got buildings going up and they cost $1 million.
There's proof of it on every street corner.
They're building skyscrapers, touching the sky.
Downtown White Plains is having a moment. The biggest development boom in decades. But in a city where signs of progress are everywhere,
keep on building and building.
There's still one place where time stands still. Very, very still. Nestled in between one new high-rise and another under construction.
Things do pile up.
Sits one of the oldest family-run small businesses in Westchester County.
Lee's Funeral Home, how may I help you?
A place families have turned to for comfort in their times of grief for more than a century.
104 years, actually, this year.
To close the book on their loved ones' lives.
They put their faith in us, and we serve the families as best we can.
But this isn't a story about loss or death. It's a story about the secret to living, long ago discovered by a mortician with a, let's just say, magical ability to uplift the living.
If you have all the lights out in the funeral home, I could walk through the funeral home and know where I'm going.
Not surprising, given Teddy Lee started working here 75 years ago at the age of 7.
This is my father right here.
Following in the footsteps of his father, who opened the place back in 1915.
As a baby, they would take me around and show me dead bodies that were in the funeral home. And they would tell me that, you know, the body couldn't harm you. No, they were dead.
Still, Teddy admits dealing with death daily can be difficult, to say the least.
I've seen people who were burned up in fires, airplane crashes.
But what he realized a long, long time ago is that the best way to live is to do what you love.
Just tell me when to stop.
And in Teddy's case, that means when he's not here preparing bodies for burial.
Let me just shuffle the cards.
You can find him up here. Or here.
1, 2, 3.
There are 3,000 practicing morticians in the state of New York. Teddy is the only one.
I like rope effects.
Who has a second job.
Sometimes I just think to myself, gee, did I do that?
As a magician.
It takes me away from the business itself. I just like it. I want to take that card. I don't know if I'm addicted to it or whatever. You can show it to everybody.
An addiction that started when he signed up for a hobbyist class at the White Plains Adult Education Center. When his children were first learning to walk.
He grew up doing magic for my brother and I. My brother and I grew out of it, and he didn't.
It's just mind-blowing the way magic is done.
Especially when you consider back when Teddy started in the 1970s, there wasn't much diversity in the field of funeral directing or magic.
There were not that many black magicians.
That's the right card.
But pretty soon, word of his unique talent got out.
A lot of people started calling on me.
And then came more awards and accolades that he could fit on his wall, including one from the oldest magic organization on the planet, who named Teddy Lee their Magician of the Year, a title once held by none other than the legend himself.
It is very cool.
Teddy has since lost track of all the gigs.
Maybe a couple of hundred or so. Maybe, I'm not sure.
And paychecks.
I don't even keep track of them. Some people pay me, and I get to the point where if they don't pay me, it's okay.
And while these days there's less shows and smaller crowds, at age 81.
My mother used to say, it's better to wear out than rust out.
Teddy insists he has no intention of slowing down.
I believe that God has something for me to do. His plan for me is to leave some kind of a legacy where we did the best we could to serve people. Or to please people.
A legacy that continues.
I might live to be 100, you never can tell.
To serve the dead.
It just disappears.
And the living.
People ask me, can you make my wife disappear?
Probably not, but what we do know is that his magical life is no illusion.
Life, you gotta make the most of it while you're living.
In White Plains.
Enjoy life.
Tara Rosenblum.
Because you never know what happens.
News 12.